Chubbuck has been huge for the Huskers in this tournament so far, along with Terrence Fedge at the forward. Piatkowski, really a guard forward, you might call him, and Boone and Johnson, the others. Boone had a big day yesterday against Missouri. For Oklahoma State, Keani Roberts, the freshman, and Fred Burley, the senior. Bryant Reeves, he has had a very good tournament for the Cowboys. Rutherford and Thompson need to pick it up a step for the Cowboys, the officials for today's game. We have Rick Walco, Stanley Reynolds, Scott Thornley, Paul Jansen is the standby official. So all the preliminaries are set. Oh, the championship is coming up. And we're back after these words from Miller Lite. Oklahoma State has won 8 of the last 10. They split this year, both teams winning handily at home. The head coach of the Huskers, Danny Nee, in his 8th year guiding Nebraska. Danny Nee trying to take the Huskers to the NCAA tournament for the 4th straight year. Well, Eddie Sutton has done a similar job with the Cowboys. Eddie Sutton in his 4th year guiding Oklahoma State. A tremendous record of 95-33 overall for Eddie Sutton. He has had a terrific run, not only at Oklahoma State, but Creighton, Arkansas, and Kentucky as well. The venerable old coach leading these Cowboys against the Huskers. Guys, what kind of tempo do you expect from this one?
Well, you're going to have some different strategy going on. Nebraska, obviously, they want to force that thing up and down the floor and try to make Bryant Reeves really work, like Gary talked about. Oklahoma State wants to keep it in a half-court situation, I think, if they can.
Yeah, that's what Oklahoma State has to do. They have to keep Big Country rested, and the way to do that is take their time on offense, turn it over, ball reversals, and they've got to cut down the sideline of Nebraska.
How tough, Gary, is the matchup Reeves with Chubbuck? How tough is that on Chubbuck?
Well, I think Danny Nee would tell you can't stop Big Country. You've got to just try and limit him to what they can do, and one way they're going to try and do is run him to death and tire him out.
And Jimmy, who do they match up the Cowboys on? Eric Piatkowski.
Well, they're going to have to try several different defenders. They're going to start off with Keonti Roberts. But you're going to have to use a taller athletic player like a Terry Collins, Brooks Thompson, maybe a little bit. Pike too tall. He can shoot over most defenders.
Well, let's see the tempo right from the get-go as Oklahoma State has the basketball. What a move by the freshman Roberts. Good start for the Cowboys. And this is Nebraska's game plan. Run if you can. And Piatkowski made some nice moves, then missed the layup.
Dave, that is what the Cowboys have to stop. They have to stop that play right there. Nebraska getting down quick.
A three. Oh, an air ball from Burley, and then a foul after Piatkowski grabbed the rebound.
I tell you, Oklahoma State's approach today to try to stop that sideline break in that transition game. Normally, Brooks Thompson and Randy Rutherford are the two guys that rotate out for defensive balance. However, this afternoon, whoever's guarding Eric Piatkowski, they're getting back on defense with Brooks Thompson and letting the two guard go and try to rebound the basketball.
Jimmy, you know, yesterday, Norm Stewart, the emphasis for the Tigers was to stop the transition game, and they couldn't get it done. We'll see if the Cowboys can. Rutherford misses on the layup. And again, here comes the transition. Blocked by Reeves, but a foul on Country.
Here's the Huskers going to come out. Show you running down quick. Here's Piatkowski. He'll take a strong to the hoop. Here comes Reeves coming up there and gets him on the wrist, and Piatkowski go to the line. The Cowboys are going to have to get out in the lane. As you see it coming back here, they cannot run down the middle of the court. They got to get outside so they can shut that pass off.
Piatkowski has scored 42 in the first round. That's a new Big A tournament record, and then 24 yesterday against Missouri.
See, if you run back to the paint defensively for Oklahoma State, Eric Piatkowski, he'll just stop around that three-point line and jump up and shoot it. That's why he's very difficult to defend. He beats you always offensively.
When he can go out and shoot it, too, from the wing, from anywhere almost.
He's a guy that you like to see all players do, and that's play without the basketball. Piatkowski is always moving. That's what makes it tough to defend.
Burley there to pick up the garbage. Well, he'll have a lot of those opportunities this afternoon. Bryant Reeves commands so much attention from the defense. A lot of help situations on Bryant. Someone's got to rotate down and block off those big guys underneath.
And really, Burley, there's a little layup by Josh, but Burley and Keonti Roberts have not rebounded well in this tournament.
And Thompson and Rutherford have not played well in this tournament so far in the two games.
So how are they in the championship? Defense carries you.
Defense and Bryant Reeves.
All right, 41% field goal defense.
2 break. And Johnson took it himself. Well, you can't let that happen. Somebody's got to come out and stop that penetration dribble around the top of the key area. Jamar Johnson got it within 6 feet of the basket that time.
Badgett just like a running interference there for Jamar Johnson. He really got in the middle of that break where you didn't want him.
That's the Nebraska football philosophy coming into effect there a little bit for the Huskers. Set that moving screen, that moving pick out there. Badgett picks up the foul.
Dave, I would have to say right now, here in the first 3 minutes of play, 3.5, this tempo is favoring Nebraska.
You hear that, Jimmy? Well, it will continue to favor Nebraska unless Oklahoma State starts knocking down shots, because that's what triggers this transition attack, is missed shots on the offensive end by the Cowboys.
Chubbuck trying to go around country.
Chubbuck remains red hot. Chubbuck has scored 23 and 17 points. You add that up with his 29 rebounds in 2 games, and Chubbuck, a definite candidate for the all-tournament team. Here comes Johnson. Nice pass to Chubbuck, but he walked with it. I don't think Chubbuck was expecting the pass. Well, I would teach my point guard, I believe, this philosophy. If you're even with the defender or even just a half step behind, you take that ball strong to the basket. Watch where Pierce is right now. Jamar Johnson's even with him. Don't risk a pass like that. You take it in, at least draw the contact. Entry fouled by Badgett, and Terrence picks up his second. Gary Thompson and Jimmy Dykes. I'm Dave Armstrong. We're in the championship game of the Phillips 66 Big 8 Conference Basketball Tournament. Nebraska and Oklahoma State, and we're tied at 7. First half action. Thompson for 3. Well, I said Thompson and Rutherford guys needed to step up, and so far they've each have a 3 in this game.
Rutherford did not have a field goal in that semifinal game. They'll have to have that perimeter shooting.
Purdue going for the Big Ten championship with that lead. Tipped out and off of Chubbuck out of bounds. Chubbuck can have some weak side help.
Well, that's the thing that the Cowboys are tough on, is reversing the ball. You watch Big Country Reeves right now. He'll go to the other side, and then you get a hold on Chubbuck.
Now Chubbuck's first foul.
And the Cowboys have to reverse that ball a lot. They have to take time off the clock, because this is going to allow Big Country to rest during his game and get the 30-plus minutes that I think they have to have out of him.
Thompson tried a long three, and Chubbuck, again, there, great position for the rebound. Whoop. Nebraska not in sync right now. Another turnover for the Cornhuskers. Eddie Sutton not happy with Rutherford about something, but he's got to be happy with the score, leading by 3. We're back after this from your friends at Phillips 66. Jimmy Dykes, Gary Thompson, I'm Dave Armstrong. We're all on hand at Kemper, watching Oklahoma State take a 3-point lead. The Cowboys with the basketball, 15:46 left to go, first half. You know, if I'm both coaches, Nebraska with a defensive change here, coming out of the timeout, a little 1-2-2, they'll double up on the basketball. It's been effective for them the last 4 or 5 games. If I'm both coaches in that last timeout, I'd settle my club down, Dave, and I say, hey, guys, we're in the finals. Let's go out and have fun this afternoon. There's no pressure on us here. We're in the NCAA tournament. Now's the time to relax and play ball and have fun. Pierce, the long rebound. Now, these guys are mainly playing for a seed today, aren't they?
And I think Nebraska is really looking to up their seed. They feel like they've really come on strong, the same way with the Cowboys.
But for the Cowboys, having only won 1 Big A championship, and for Nebraska never having won it, yeah, there might be a little more pressure on them than, say, someone like Missouri or Kansas. Chubbuck took it right over country. Well, obviously, he had to get a little extra arc on the ball as he got it up and used the glass. I don't think it was an intentional deal, but... So far, it's Chubbuck 4, Country still 0.
Chubbuck going inside. Watch Chubbuck now. And a fake back out, comes to this side. Big Country up there. He has to put, as Jimmy said, high off that glass. And I don't think he was intending to bank that baby. I didn't hear him call bank either.
Okay, all right. Jamie Horsey's not getting credit for that one. And a walk on the part of Rutherford. Talk about a game of horse. I was talking with Brooks Thompson, Eric Piatkowski there out there at the shoot-around just about 30 minutes prior to tip-off. As let's just have a horse game between you two and decide this thing. And Brooks, and man, the way this guy's shooting, I would never get a letter on him. Piatkowski is on rebound, yes. His first field goal, he has 3 points.
The dangerous guy on the offensive follow is a shooter. You must check the shooter.
Especially a guy 6'7 like Eric Piatkowski that is well-trained in following his shot. Marines will track it down. In the corner, Pierce, and there's Piatkowski sealing Country off. Well, that was lucky for Badgett. Off Anita Boone.
You see those Cowboys, they really cut down the driving lanes.
Chubbuck trying to take it himself, and that one well off target from three, and Country racing down court. That went off Country and out of bounds. What a play by Piatkowski. Wow. Country still trying to figure out what happened. Piatkowski knows. Yeah, that guy right there. Watch the great lead pass by Brooks Thompson. But watch Eric Piatkowski. He gets it done, folks, on both ends. He gets his hand in there on top of that basketball, and then Brad Reeves steps out of bounds. Eric Piatkowski really starting to prove his worth as an NBA player.
Well, we've had a reversal. We had the foul called on the play.
They called a foul on Chubbuck on the play. So Bruce Chubbuck has picked up his second foul. The foul was not on Piatkowski, who slapped the ball away cleanly. It was on Chubbuck for pushing Reeves out of bounds. Now Best checks in, and Chubbuck, he's going to have to be careful with his two fouls. Zone defense for Nebraska on the inbounds play. Well, it's a 2-3 sliding zone. When that ball goes to the corner, the wingman rotates to the offside like Piatkowski did there, and there's where the shots occur from against him. Keontae Roberts, his second.
Well, that's going to be a key foul. Is on Chubbuck, his second. Here's Country running the floor. Piatkowski gets there, and then there's where the foul is called on Chubbuck coming over Reeves and forcing him out of bounds.
I didn't see it. The ball, the play had already gone through, and they just, both players were coming down to the floor. I don't think the contact affected the shot. That's a no call. I think it is.
It didn't affect the shot, but it affected him recovering the ball going out of bounds because he steps on the out of bounds as he recovers. That's where the call was made.
So you think it was a good call?
I think it's a good call.
All right, that's why we have you guys both here. And now Reeves, he's caught pushing off, and uh-oh, Eddie Sutton going, golly, two on Country. Well, see, he's making up for that last one. See, the official agrees with me. That first one shouldn't have been. But you watch right here, Bryant Reeves. Now, that's where he's tough. You can't allow him to get right there. Oh, boy.
The whole thing about officiating is disadvantage, advantage, or advantage, disadvantage.
It depends on your perspective, too, Gary, which coach you are, so whether it's an advantage or disadvantage. Slapped away clean, but then off of Manzer and out of bounds. Manzer was the guy yesterday that really spurred the Cowboys on in the second half in their win against Kansas. Yeah, he's playing his best basketball right now for Eddie Sutton at a key time. You get in tournament-type situations, playing 3 games in a row, maybe 2 games next week. You got to have some productivity off that bench, and he's giving him offensive punch as well as solid ball-handling skills. Boone too strong, but Best will track it down. Nebraska leading by one with 12 to go, first half. Chubbuck, nope. Boy, Reeves, who went down for the count many times yesterday, has to pick himself up again. Gary, you talked about fatigue with Country. All the times he has to pick himself up, that's got to add to it.
And then you saw him on that play we had to work on.
feet long, weighs over 2 tons, has dual airbags, anti-lock brakes, and a sophisticated impact management system. The new Neon also has dual airbags, available anti-lock brakes, and a sophisticated impact management system. The rich, it would appear, do not have it all. Say hello to Neon. $89.75 for starters, $12.5 nicely loaded.
You know those credit card commercials where they tell you to jaunt off to some exotic paradise? This isn't one of them, okay? We're taking our MasterCard to the supermarket. How's that for exotic? Actually, I guess it is kind of exotic. I mean, you've got a MasterCard. They've got tropical fruit and crystal clear water, right? And now, no card is more accepted on the planet, including supermarkets. And it's smart to use your monthly statement to keep track of your grocery spending. I mean, the supermarket isn't exactly paradise, but at least you can drink the water. MasterCard. It's more than a credit card. It's smart money.
Without knowing, American businesses wasted $1 billion last year by using the wrong long-distance company. $1 billion that could have been reinvested in those businesses. That's why MCI announces a $1 billion stimulus plan for American business. Get all the savings from Proof Positive, plus we'll send you a check that doubles your savings every time you get a Proof Positive statement this year. Call and make the most stimulating investment of all, an investment in your business.
Take the Gillette 3-Point Challenge, flip the coupon in today's newspaper, go to a participating retailer to see if you've won a shot at $1 million. No purchase necessary, void where prohibited. I'm Dave Armstrong, along with Gary Thompson and Jimmy Dykes, Bruce Chubbuck, and the Cornhuskers leading by one right now. Chubbuck's going to rest for a while with his 2 fouls. Great defensive effort so far by Bruce Chubbuck. Big Country with no points. And Bruce Chubbuck responsible for that. Who guards him now? Best? Best will have to, but he's got the size to do it.
And he's been playing well, too.
And shooting well right there. That's a 2 from Best. No, he came in as the leading rebounder, the league he transferred in from, but he can step out on the perimeter and shoot it. That's a tough matchup now for Bryant Reeves. No, we understand now Scott Pierce of Oklahoma State. Possible fractured hand. He's being taken into the locker room now for x-rays. We'll get your report. See, this Nebraska team is really alert. They're aggressive. They're very quick reacting to the ball on the defensive end of the floor. They weren't like that in January when they had that slump. Boy, Rutherford
had
trouble getting it going. And Reeves, his shot well shy. Reeves 0 for 5 from the field. Here comes Boone. Again, Oklahoma State, Gary, and I think when they get back in that transition defense, they can't run to the paint. They got to get out and cover people better than that on the wings. 8 straight by the Huskers to take a 5-point lead.
I agree with you. They've got to get out in those running lanes and cover that.
Well, MCI proof positive, guys, that Jerron Boone and the Huskers can really get it going on the break.
Well, here's what we're talking about. You watch. When Nebraska gains possession here off a great defensive stop for one. Now watch. Watch Oklahoma State defensively. Look, one guy in the lane, 2, 3, 4 guys in the paint right there. Somebody's got to come out and stop that basketball.
It's an 8-0 run by the Huskers right now. Good ball movement there.
That stops it. Rutherford is second tray. Good 3-point shooter, Rutherford and Thompson both. Best again. That one's short. But there's that shooter you're talking about, Gary, getting his own rebound.
Didn't take it up strong. I don't know if he lost it. He just kind of tried to pooch it up there. Should have really muscled it to the bucket.
Looked like he was taking a peek to see where Country was. Burley. Oh, and now 5 straight by the Cowboys to tie it. Kowski taking it strong to the hole and a foul on Burley. Hey, don't forget, join us at halftime. We'll update Big 8 Conference women's basketball on our Volkswagen Women's Halftime Report. Nebraska may be as good a team as I've seen in some time in the Big 8. Maybe like harkens back to the Oklahoma teams. That, boy, they really get it and fly on that break, guys.
I tell you where I think they've really improved throughout the year, Gary, and we both watched them several times. I think they're much better now knowing when to run and when not to run. Early in the year, they ran every time. Now, if they don't have the numbers, they're a little bit better at bringing it back out and running their offense.
I think they got back to that. They went through that 4-game losing streak shooting 39%, and that was part of the problem. They come down, just start casting up threes,
yeah.
And when the good opportunity wasn't there, they got back to fundamentals, and as you said,
there, Jerron Boone, who's on my all I know what I need to work on over the summer team. That guy got 11 offensive rebounds for the year, a 6'6 guy.
You're on what team?
I know what I need to work on over the summer team. I mean, that guy right there steps right out. It's obvious where he needs to improve.
Three. Came
the game. He was out there shooting some perimeter shots. They weren't falling. He said, Jimmy, don't worry about it. I'm just getting rid of my misses early. Kind of like I do on the golf. On the golf course, you know, that get that practice.
No, you don't. You don't get rid of your mistakes early. I've seen you make a lot of them once you get out there, too.
No, I geared all my bad shots on the practice tee.
Yeah, right.
You, in your dreams, you do. Sutton checking in, the coach's son, Scott.
Well, Strickland now 6 out of 9 in this tournament from three-point range, so he evidently got the misses out in practice.
Yeah, he sure did. Thompson having a better game, guys. Well, you knew he's capable. I really feel like he's a prototype NBA 2 guard. It has really helped him, I think, get to the next level by having to play the point in college, because he now has explosive moves with the basketball in his hands. He's obviously a great three-point shooter and a fierce defensive competitor, Gary.
I think in the first two games, maybe he was trying to maybe do a little too much and trying to force the action.
Well, he's put this team on his shoulders today. Thompson, he has 8 points to lead all scorers. Melvin Brooks will inbound it for the Huskers, or the Skurs, as we called them yesterday. We were reminded last night that Nebraska fans kind of like that right now.
And is it also, though, that not all Nebraska fans refer to them as the Skurs, just some fans?
Somebody said, told us the other day that the new slang for the Huskers, they just take off the husk part, just call them the Skurs. I'm not sure. Well, I guess that would work. You got the boys and the Skurs here today. That foul on Terry Collins. He picks up his first, and that's going to put Oklahoma State over that limit. And Piatkowski is 2 of 4 from the line. We'll go to the stripe.
1-1, guys. 1-1.
You know, you got two different defensive philosophies going on in this game right now. Anytime the ball goes into the post for Oklahoma State, you got an automatic double up on the low blocks. When the ball goes into the post for Nebraska, Oklahoma State is staying out there and shadowing those shooters. So far, Piatkowski struggling a little bit. At the line, he is 2 of 5. And from the field, Piatkowski 2 of 6. Got it. He's fouled. Reeves starting to heat things up. MCI proof positive. You get the ball to Reeves, and he can do some damage. I tell you what, Bryant Reeves has really developed as a low post player, and this is very important, and Bryant Reeves understands it. Where you post up in the blocks, you see number 34 right here for Nebraska on that free throw stripe about to box off. You need to be at least there or above towards that free throw stripe if you're a low post player. If you post up too low, Dave, when you catch it, it limits where you can go offensively. Reeves has become a free throw shooting machine. He hit 11 straight in his game yesterday against Kansas, 15 of 17 from the line in his 27 points. Strickland has to go off his foot out of bounds.
Jimmy, I think for Oklahoma State, too, when you post up on that block, rather than getting in the middle of the lane, you eliminate some of the help coming to you.
Yeah, you much greater distance to come over and cover. You know, at Oklahoma State, you watch, when that ball goes to the post today, they're very good at hitting the post and relocating. You don't see that ball go in and the other four perimeter players stand. They hit and move and give Bryant Reeves an outlet.
That's one of the first things you're taught. Hit the post and slide. Don't be stay in that same position. Bad pass.
Terrible pass. That was too low for Calvin Rayford, much less Drake. Bryant Reeves. Piatkowski trying to weave through traffic, could not. Screen. He wanted to travel. Shot clock at 5. Reeves, no. Reeves. Uh-oh, his third foul. Well, appreciate the effort by both clubs here. You see the shot clock going down, so no better play than get it to Bryant Reeves. But watch Bryant come back in the play here. It comes over the top of Melvin Brooks. Now, he's 7 feet tall, and sometimes he can get away with that, but he was on his back that time. Coaching decision, guys. 3 fouls, 4:26 to go till halftime. You leave him in?
He's going to take him out. Ian Phillips just came off the bench right now. He'll try and protect him, I think, for the last 4 minutes. You know, it's funny. The hustle of Oklahoma
Oklahoma State there caused his third foul. The other kids are on the boards keeping it alive. It came back on this side, and now his aggressiveness goes to it, and he goes over the back and picks up his third.
Yeah, he's too valuable. There's no decision to be made there. He's got to sit for the remainder of the half. Now, the fear of the Cowboys is that the Cornhuskers don't get too big a lead before the half.
Well, now is when I really play a half-court game. I'm going to minimize the possessions of Nebraska. I'm going to turn it over, each possession, and eat up this clock.
Good pass. Thompson into Phillips. Yeah, great penetration by Brooks Thompson, and Ian Phillips with a left-hand shot. Kid's a hard worker. He's developing into a pretty solid player.
Ian Phillips had just 3 points in his last 15 games, but hits that one. Boone short. Magic tracks it down.
The Cowboys had trouble against Kansas yesterday afternoon rebounding, and they're having some problems here again on the defensive glass.
Strickland's got eight. Oh, see a spark plug off that bench. Jimmy, you called him yesterday the best athlete, overall athlete in the Big 8 Conference. Gary, would you agree with that?
I think he is. I talked with him in the hotel today coming down about his baseball. He says he'll report in May, and we'll find out then. So we've talked about him being a major league prospect, a center fielder. He's got great speed.
Really trying to get this thing in an up-tempo situation. Ian Phillips continues to get the job done in substitution role for Bryant Reeves right now. Nebraska defensively, now they really turn up the heat on those perimeter players because they can extend that defense without that low post scoring threat in the game right there, Bryant Reeves. And he does look, he's taking a little nap over there. That guy looks a little tired.
I'm saying, guys, I think he looks tired today.
Well, he played 37 minutes
right.
and 32 back-to-back. You're going for the third night, and that's a load for a big guy like that.
That's what I'm saying. And a lot of times when you are tired, you pick up a lot of fouls that you might not normally.
But, you know, Bryant Reeves is hard to read as far as does he look tired, because he always kind of has that Snow White, I'm one of the sleepy guys of the Seven Dwarfs look about him. You know, I mean, he doesn't always have that bright-eyed, bushy-tailed approach about it.
Ian Phillip misses them both.
Strickland. He's feeling it. That's a two. He had his foot on the line. But Strickland has 10 first half off the bench points. Well, see, Nebraska has perimeter players that can shoot the three and then blow by you on the dribble. Strickland and Piatkowski in particular, very difficult to stop them. Blocked. Wow. Two on one. Three on one. Four on one. Wow. Great hustle. Great effort by Nebraska. You had some Oklahoma State guys weren't even across half court yet. Nebraska killed them on the board.
I'll tell you what happens. A team stops on this end, worried about the foul not being called. Nebraska blows it by and takes advantage.
Thompson trying to quiet this Nebraska crowd, and he gets the Cowboy crowd to cheer. Under two to go, first half. 3-point Nebraska lead.
Well, Thompson, a great 3-point shooter percentage-wise. Only the second player in the Big 8 Conference to go over 100 threes in the season. The other guy, Terry Brown. Surprise, though, Jimmy, are you the way the Cowboys are just attacking on offense? I thought they'd really come out and turn the ball over.
Well, there's a fine line there from a coaching standpoint of controlling the tempo and losing your aggressiveness. And certainly with the guard play they have, Brooks Thompson, Randy Rutherford, their game is all about aggressiveness. Shot clock is at three with Thompson releasing and hitting a three. 14 for Thompson in the first half.
Johnson's foul, that one on Sutton. Boy, Brooks Thompson has single-handedly kept the Cowboys in this one with his three-point shooting with Reeves on the bench.
Jimmy, you know Eddie Sutton's philosophy very, very well. And I know in that case, he's going to say, make him shoot the ball in on that foul right there. You don't want to go up and foul that guy. Make him shoot in
this discussion about? He just said,
call
I'm asking you
ways.
To call it both ways, please. But you're right, I tell you what, there are some things that will get you on the bench from a coaching standpoint if you're playing for Eddie Sutton, and one of them is a defensive mental mistake. Fouling the perimeter jump shot is one of them. 59 seconds to go till halftime. 34-33. There's a one-point Husker lead when Reeves went to that bench.
Husker's just 4 of 8 at the free throw line. They've shot 79% from the line in this tournament.
And now a foul. That one on Melvin Brooks. And now, no laughing matter, Mel Brooks picks up his third.
Jimmy, you're a fan of his, aren't you? I mean, you like to get that Mel Brooks in a lot.
Oh, man. Watch a lot of movies?
Great comedian. Oh,
Blazing Saddles, one of the all-time classics. This telecast, a copyrighted presentation of Raycom Incorporated, intended solely for the private use of our audience. Any rebroadcast or other use of this telecast without the express prior written consent of Raycom is prohibited. Ian Phillip missed his only 2 free throw attempts so far in this game.
Going back to a man-to-man
Rutherford, a three. He's got three of those this game. Tied again. 36 all.
Again, the Cowboys getting that help where they needed, that perimeter shooting. Thompson, 14 first half points.
Great pass.
Yes, sir. those. Chubbuck will track it down. Oh, quick play by Burley. Watch the spacing right now on offense for Oklahoma State. They're very spread. That really hurts as far as doubling up on Bryant Reeves when he catches it. Air ball from Roberts. And he'll hear the chant.
That's not his shot.
14-32 to go to the championship. Nebraska by one.
But you have to know your player. You have to know your strengths. That is not a shot for Keontae Roberts out the three-point line, and he's sitting down on the bench as a result of it.
I'll tell you what, I think always important in shot selection, you've got to know three things: time, score, and momentum. How much time's left, or how much time's left on the shot clock, what the score is, and who has the momentum, and both teams are trying to establish that right now. So you can't have questionable shot selection from Keontae Roberts. Jaron Boone with some momentum in the second half. He has 5 second half points, and Nebraska with a 4-point lead. Got to change defensively for Nebraska. There's a little bit of a chaser going on Rutherford and Thompson. The other three guys playing a zone inside, a triangle and two. Reeves got a tip of his own miss.
Results with a triangle two in Stillwater earlier in the season against Oklahoma State. They didn't have as much success in here in the tournament with Oklahoma State. So this isn't going to be something new now for the Cowboys. They've faced it before, but Danny Knees looking at something that gave him some problems earlier.
Reeves, that was good defense with 3 fouls. He changed the shot of Chubby.
Thank you.
second half, and it was spectacular. Talk about the flow of this ball game and who's establishing what. Nebraska has only shot the ball 44 times, Oklahoma State 52 attempts. So that's telling you right there the storyline as we start clicking down with about 10 minutes to go. Foul from behind on Best. Strickland went down hard. He thought he was fouled.
You see good ball movement here by the Cowboys. Coming in, a penetration, kick it outside. Now they go in, and great entry pass there. And Reeves coming, and then Best from behind with the foul. And down goes, who's that, Strickland?
That was the big red sandwich from the Huskers. And Reeves will go to the line.
Might be a Runza sandwich. If you're familiar with Nebraska, the Runzas are big during the football game.
Yeah. This to pull the Cowboys to within one. Boy, that's some string for him, isn't it? So Danny Nee told me before the ball game, he said, Jimmy, we need spurts, and we need to limit their second chance opportunities. But very difficult to spurt, I think, against an Oklahoma State team because they don't turn the ball over much, and usually they take high percentage shots.
You know, that tip-in by Piekowski was the first second chance points of the half for Nebraska. Oklahoma State's done a good job of shutting
it
off.
Piekowski being a little more aggressive now, takes it to the hole, and he's fouled. We talk about an outstanding family background. That guy right there, he's got brothers playing basketball all over the place. We talked at breakfast with his family, and they got a 12-hour drive home, and their youngest son starts his high school state tournament next week. So Piekowski's loves the round ball. Strickland for three. And he loves the three ball from the corner pocket, Eric Strickland.
That's one of their favorite plays.
4-point Nebraska lead. 10:16 to go. Strickland over the back. Well, he makes something happen out there, though. Danny says, let's calm down just a little bit, though.
A little bit. He's the type of player you can't harness, though. I mean, his ability is just to fly at you, be aggressive. Yeah. So sometimes he's going to make some mistakes, but you got to live with that.
There's Benji getting some more TV time, pushing up that 13. That's a 1-3-1 half-court defense. You know, that writing looked a little familiar. Maybe he was the one making that Jimmy Dykes sign. You're relentless. You're like Daryl Cunningham. You're relentless.
I saw Benji eat steaks last night. Instead of those tube steaks.
And a new pair of cowboy boots. You're Russian now. They never showed that sign. Oh, that one got through to Strickland somehow.
Strickland had Brooks on the baseline. I don't know if he didn't see him. He should have given it to him.
Well, special play here. Blue calls from the sidelines. Starts in a box set. Immediately posts up Piekowski on the block. He has his advantage height-wise on Manzer. Outmanned Manzer. Brendan, who was a spark plug yesterday, scoreless today. While in Kansas City, winners of the Phillips 66 Super Clean Sweepstakes staying at the Adams Mark Hotel. First prize winners will stay at the beautiful Radisson Resort Hotel in Scottsdale, Arizona. French 35 on the shot clock. Strickland going for another three. Reeves the long rebound. Did you see his hands there? He got one hand on it, Gary, and then just snatched it in. A lot of big guys don't have those soft paws like I like to see out of a seven-footer.
He reminds you of a kid that played at Iowa State, Victor Alexander.
Yes.
Two of the best pair of hands I've seen on a big guy.
Yes, sir. Rutherford with five trays in this one, and we've got a one-point game again. Another foul against him. That's on Strickland, and it'll be his third. Now, Dave, you asked me earlier in the tournament, do you think Brant Reeves is athletic? Watch him right here. He jumps once, he jumps twice, he jumps three times before he gets it. Now, not a lot of seven-footers in college basketball can do that quickly. Jump, 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 and secure the rebound. Then have those suction cup hands of his, certainly.
And take 290 pounds with you.
Yeah. Strickland that time snuck in front of him. The baseball pass to Piekowski. Roberts. Now Chubbuck. Oh, boy. Work points right there by Bruce Chubbuck. He just wanted the basketball a little bit more than Oklahoma State and got it to go down.
Well, it was a smart play there on Reeves. He let him take the shot. He didn't go after it. He's in foul trouble. As smart as you said by Chubbuck of taking it right to it.
Oh, he pushed me.
Reeves, you can hear someone in there. Oh, he pushed me. And Reeves goes flying to the bench. Shot clock, you see there. Number seven, Boone's got to hurry.
Rutherford. And the key thing, they're slapping in and taking his hand out of there so he doesn't come away with getting a foul. Makes him double pump it. Boom! Give it up. There you go. Jamar! You know, I fought Thompson there. He goes to the officials as he got me on the arm. Instead of hustling back and getting back and trying to save the play, he gave Nebraska an advantage. Timeout, Cowboys!
He concentrates on the guard play in this game. We see both teams, their guards are really doing well. Strickland Johnson, 26 points to add to Eric Piatkowski. They needed that today. Rutherford and Thompson, boy, you get those guys clicking with Big Country inside. They're tough. But with 5:11 to go to these, both teams go to their star players, Piatkowski and Reed.
Oh,
the foul there is going to be on Keonte Roberts, his fourth. Yeah, I think Nebraska caught Oklahoma State a little lackadaisical coming out of that timeout. They changed the defense, ran and jumped the first inbounds pass and got the strip.
Well, the point, though, is that Piatkowski is just one bucket this half. Reeves starting to pick up the pace a little bit. With 5:05 to go, do these guys go more to their marquee players or do they just play in the flow of the game?
Well, I think you can't dictate certainly who's taking every shot down. I think they have to be involved as far as the first and second option in our offense, but then you've got to make sure you keep that well-balanced attack going, and both teams can because they got guys that can step up and hit shots. Four-point Nebraska lead. The Huskers looking for their first ever Big 8 championship. They were in the finals in 91, lost that game. Oklahoma State looking for only their second Big 8 tournament championship. They won 11 years ago in 1983.
Again, the Cowboys trying to spread the court, which should open up the middle on Big Country.
Reeves, there it is, Gary. You called it. And from the Big Ten, you saw the Purdue one. Here it's Nebraska by two with 4.5 to go. Piatkowski for three. He's been cold today, but the long rebound comes out to Melvin Brooks. You know, we just got word from the locker room. Scott Pierce had that right hand x-rayed, and it is fractured. Good news for the Cowboys as they head to the NCAA.
Think how many times now Reeves has been involved in crucial plays down on this end, keeping the ball alive, coming away with the rebound.
Tough day today, too. Guys, a cheerleader for Oklahoma State dislocated his shoulder in the halftime routine. So, boy, everybody's going down. Reeves is bumped. He'll go back to the line again. Yeah, and I got a nod on my head from you two guys hammering me about that sign earlier.
Great entry pass again. Here's Piatkowski. Comes over and jams him too quick. The big guy will go to the line. We'll see if he can continue to shoot those free throws as well as he did last night.
5 of 6 so far today.
Cowboys getting done what they want right now. That's getting this big guy the ball down low.
Well, and they're doing it by keeping that 15, 16-foot spacing on the perimeter. Therefore, Nebraska, very difficult to go run and double. Behind Piatkowski. Now Rutherford for three. There's a foul. That's on Thompson. His third.
Dave, execution in the game of basketball, so important. If that pass is on the mark, it's 2 points for the Huskers on this other end.
Eddie Sutton taking a peek at the clock and scratching the brow, trying to figure out a way for his team to win this thing. Trailing by two with 3:42 to go. The minds are spinning for both me and Sutton now, aren't they? We've got a lot of things to concern yourself with. You got to have assistants on the bench or making sure you understand how many timeouts we got, who's in foul trouble, who's hot force. You got to have defensive matchups down. And then, as always, you got to have some shots called for you.
All you do is you turn your offense, you run it over, turn it over 2-3 times, then you jump up and take a three.
It's a simple deal.
Yeah.
From 25 feet. Now, for Oklahoma State, you run your offense, and throw it to the big guy right there. And another foul. Reeves goes back to the line. He's already set a tournament record with 38 free throw makes in this Phillips 66 Big 8 tournament. He'll go back to the line again. He just missed his last attempt. Piatkowski going to get a late blow here with 3:04 to go. Mm-hmm. to it the most. And he wanted to make a point with him. He's having a conversation with him on the bench. See right there, instead of wasting the timeout, just take him out of the game, set him down, get your point across, and get him back in. 5 of 8 for Reeves at the line. I'll tell you what, Nebraska, the next time Oklahoma State shoots a free throw, they better box off better, because Rutherford, no one checked him. He was there in case it came off.
Score from the Metro, a bit of a surprise. Louisville was heavily favored in that game.
Yeah, Louisville, there's a school I wanted to go to out of high school. I didn't like the way they recruited me, though. Never wrote me, never called, never came to see me play. Melvin Brooks comes up big.
Not the place you want to try and save a ball right there. Center it right back underneath their basket.
Exactly.
And wouldn't you know it, it was Brooks who came in for Piotrowski.
Watch the effort right here. You see Brooks get it up, and it goes down. And that's an enthusiasm basket right now for Nebraska. Look at that boy, all that hand slapping and high-fiving. You like celebration and recognition from your teammates that you did something good.
Right now, the Huskers have their biggest lead, 6. Brooks to make it 7.
Brooks is getting Danny Nee some good playing time in this ball game.
Yeah, he
not just because of that play. Yeah,
he and Tom Best, I think, in this tournament, they've stepped up what they needed to do off the bench.
Can Nebraska win their first ever Big 8 tournament championship? Brooks Thompson said, not yet, you can't.
There's the competitiveness coming out in that young man.
Well, Nebraska, the last few minutes of the ballgame, they can't get into we're going to outscore you attitude. They got to make sure they stay solid on the defensive end. You can't give up layups like that with 2.5 to go.
You see the time remaining.
Well, this is the best way to take time off the clock. That little delay, double stack high, very difficult to defend.
And a foul. Brooks. Boy, he's coming up big now for the Huskers.
Rutherford working hard to pick up the foul. How far in advance do the coaches think, guys? I know in baseball they try to think 2-3 innings ahead. How far in basketball can you think ahead with 2:05 to go? Are you thinking just that second, or do you think, well, if this happens 30 seconds from now or something like that?
I think you look ahead 2 or 3 possessions, and you got to certainly a key foul can dictate what you got to do strategy-wise.
Now, what do you think about Nebraska? Hit these 2 free throws. They're going to have a 7-point lead. Are they going to start running a little clock on the next possession?
Yeah.
And it likes to attack.
Yeah. They got it. Look at second half shooting for Nebraska, getting a lot of things done inside, but some balanced scoring. See, that's what you got to have. What Nebraska has to do, assistant coach, they got to stay aggressive in their offense, but more importantly, solid now defense in a half-court situation.
Strickland off the miss.
Now, run that baby down every time if you're Nebraska, and you're going to go out of here as the Big 8 tournament champions for the first time in the 98-year history of Nebraska basketball.
That's what I know what I was going to do. I'm going to run clock. I don't care how aggressive I've been before. Talked about time, scoring.
Johnson, no.
That's not the shot they wanted there.
No. Shot clock was down to 7.
Thompson. Reeves.
Piotrowski. Boy, did he will that one into his arms. Now Johnson.
That could be a clincher.
And he's fouled. Pizza Hut delivery of the game.
Eric Piotrowski said, this rebound is for all the Husker fans in a Big 8 tournament championship. I got to have it, and I went and got it, and he triggered things going the other way for the clincher, I think, for Nebraska. Look at that right there. That's great execution and enthusiasm. Look up and down that bench.
They are excited, aren't they?
Oh, that's great to see.
They should be. Nebraska came in
to this tournament, maybe the one of the hottest team, maybe the hottest team in the Big 8 Conference. I know Missouri had that streak going, but boy, I think Nebraska was playing the best basketball coming in.
They've won five of their last six and could have had six out of six if it hadn't been for that game at Missouri.
That could have been the clincher right there. A 10-point lead with 1:06 to go. 17 seconds ago, Nebraska has called a timeout to try to freeze Rutherford at the line. Randy will be going to the stripe for his first time in this game, but an 85% free throw shooter on the year. He needs to make all three, doesn't he, guys?
Yeah, he's got to make all three to get this thing now down to a one-possession game. What you got to talk about in both huddles, Oklahoma State, okay, we're going to make all three free throws. Set that in your player's mind and say, that's a done issue now. After we make all three, let's pick up a four-court pressure. If we can get a quick inbound steal, let's get it. Then, if not, we're going to have to come down and get them on the foul stripe again, because if not, they're going to run the clock out. How much are the Cowboys handcuffed by the fact they have no timeouts remaining?
Well, that's
huge, isn't it?
Right, that is a problem for them. The other thing, going back to Oklahoma State, they got to be thinking, as you said earlier, Jimmy, use your timeouts to stay possession of the basketball. That is the key right now, keeping possession of the basketball.
Will be interesting to see the full court pressure Oklahoma State's put on. There's two ways to do it. You can put a guy guarding the man out of bounds, and then all other defenders pick up, or take him off the guy guarding the throwing of inbounds pass, use him as a center fielder, and let everyone face guard. That's your best way, I think, of coming up with a steal. And we'll have to wait to see after the free throws how they drew it up in the huddle.
Not easy to make history, is it? Nebraska looking for their first ever championship, and it is not easy.
Now it's two possessions again.
Now remember this. The last time Oklahoma State, two or three possessions, goes on the free throw strike, Nebraska did not box off very well, Gary. We talked about it.
If you're Nebraska, Piatkowski's got to check out Collins. Tom Best has to check off Roberts. Strickland has to check off Manzer. Jamar Johnson has to step in front of Rutherford.
I think with two possession game now, well, you got to get the foul quick. You got to foul right now.
Yeah, right.
They foul Best. He was trying to get rid of it. Best, the worst free throw shooter out there at 62%.
Zero for zero.
15 seconds to go. Best, his first free throw attempt here today.
I mean, what a job that Best and Brooks have done for this club on the boards. Best with 10 rebounds, Brooks with 8.
This will be a two-shot foul. Oklahoma State over the 10-foul limit. He hits them both, and it's over. It's a three-possession game again. A six-point lead now. Seven would be too big a hill for the Cowboys to climb. There you go. We can start celebrating in Lincoln. Manzer.
Thanks for joining us.